What's happening, motherfuckers? This is my truck. It's dirty as fuck, but I don't give a shit. This is my fag pole AR-15. Just kidding, it's badass. But this is my PWS AR-15. That is an Arsenal AK-47. And it is some juice. Yeah. Alright, this is gonna be a overview of the PWS mk114, mainly the long stroke piston system, which is becoming more popular in the AR scene. Now, you may be wondering why I have an AK-47 next to an AR-15, and that will become very clear in just a moment. But many people are very familiar with the gas impingement system, where basically the bolt carrier's got a gas key. There's a gas tube that runs into the gas key. All the gases are expelled out in here, and you know, this, it gets dirty, it gets hot. Now what people are doing now is they're going to a piston design, which is essentially what the AK is running off of, and it is a much more reliable system. Essentially, there's a vent hole up here, a gas port, where the gases are expelled out here, pushing the piston rod back instead of inside of the receiver. So I can shoot about 400 or 500 rounds out of this thing and take the bolt out and actually hold it, and it's cool to the touch and spick span fucking clean. So anyways, that's just kind of a short overview of the piston driven. Now there is a difference. You got your short stroke and your long stroke. Now this rifle here is a long stroke piston. This is as close as you'll come to this. Now everybody knows that the AK-47 is just about the most reliable rifle out there. I mean, you gotta be fucking stupid not to know that. But but if you don't, take this thing out real quick. Now, I'm a professional one-hander cameraman here, so bear with me. Let me fuck some shit up. Take that out. Got your recoil spring there. Put the hammer back. Now, I have not cleaned these since I last fired it the other day, so if you're wondering why my shit's a little dirty, that is why. Okay. So, find a place to put this here. That is the piston system on an AK-47. Now, the whole reason why I got the AK next to the MK AR-15, open this sucker up here. Got almost an identical piston system. Almost identical. Slightly different bolt carrier. More sophisticated bolt. This hinge here is actually to prevent carrier tilt. So yeah, those are basically identical. They designed this rifle off of the most reliable rifle in the world. This is essentially an AK hidden inside of an AR. I mean, fucking Red Jacket wishes they can fucking build this shit, man. I mean, this is top of the line AR. This is not cheap. This is a PWS MK114. Primary weapon systems. I paid about $2,000 out the door just for the rifle. That's not including the grips, EOTEX, freaking tactical lasers and shits. All the slings and stuff. So yeah, $2,000 just for the piston driven. The piston driven, there is quite a bit of a price difference, but the reliability compared to the AK just just can't be beat. So again, here's my AR bolt carrier piston, and this is the AK piston. And there is a couple different versions of this. This is a long stroke. They have a short stroke version, which has some springs and a connecting rod, which I think is just a bunch of bullshit. I mean, it's just more pieces and shit. So this right here, I think, is the most simple, reliable system there is. I mean, I've hardly ever cleaned this bolt face. I mean, I've already fired like 1,500 rounds through this, and that's what it looks like. I mean, I clean the piston off, I clean the barrel out, I clean the chambers and shit, but I really haven't had a need to even touch this thing. I just put a little bit of lube in there every once in a while, and that is, I haven't touched that since I bought the rifle, basically. I mean, everything stays clean, there's no gases that come out there, everything comes out over here. You can actually see it's kind of darker on the paint where the gases have been coming out. But, yeah, this is an overview of my badass MK AR Raper here. And a nice shot of my AK, which I had just finished the grips on, so. Peace out, bitches.